Good morning, dear students. Today we will continue auxiliary and modal verbs. In last video lecture, we were talking about auxiliary and modal verbs. And auxiliary verbs be, do, and have. Today we will talk about the modal verbs. These are also auxiliary, but separately we call it modal verbs. These are also auxiliary verbs. Here some modal verbs and use and examples are given, so we will understand how they are used in sentences. So here first can, and can is used to express ability, to express permission, to get permission, and to seek permission, to give permission and request also, and to express offer. So here can is used, and how it is used to express ability. He can speak 5 languages. So this is his ability, that he can speak 5 languages. So can is used to express ability also. Here permission, to give permission or to demand permission. Can I use your phone? So can I use your phone? Here can is used to take permission, and to give permission, na, can is also used. Here it is used to for request also. Can I have a glass of water, please? So this is the request, na, when we request to someone, na, to have something, in that case, na, can is also used. And to express, to give, offer, can I help you? So here can is also used to express offer. Here could is the past form of can. To express ability, the past, could is used, and in request also could is used. Here ability means can is used to express ability, and could is also used to express ability. And can is used to express request, and could is also used to express request. Both can and could we can use in ability and request. Here to express the ability of the past, we use could. How? I could swim when I was 7. When I was 7, in the sense when I was 7 years old. So could is also used to express ability in the past. And how could is used to express request or to show request? Could you get me a ticket? So could you get me a ticket? Here it is used to request, to for request and ability also. Here next is may and might. Now might is the past of may. Here may is used to take permission and to give permission both. Here how may is used to give permission. Here you may use my computer. So you may use my computer, may is used to give the permission, that you can use my permission, I am giving you can use my computer, that I am giving you permission, and I have to use my computer. Second number, to take permission. May I come in? Okay, may I come in here? In this sentence, may is used to take permission. Okay, to express possibility. He may come today. Okay, he may come today. May is used to show the possibility, and might is also used to show the possibility. Means if the possibility is weak, might is used. If the possibility is strong, may is used. Okay, so he may come today. This is the, that it shows that the possibility that he may come today. And he might come today, it means, you know, there is less possibility that he might come today. Okay, so both may and might are used to give the permission, take the permission, to express possibility either weak or strong. Here might is also used to express possibility. Might is used to permission. He might go now. Okay, and for possibility he might come today. So might and may both are used to express permission, possibility, permission and possibility. Here students, next is will. Will is used to express future action. In your future also, perhaps it will rain tonight. So here it will rain tonight. It expresses about the future action. Second use of will for request. Will you give me a lift? So here he is requesting. Someone is requesting. Will you give me a lift? And it is used. Will is used for offer also. Will you have some tea? Here he offers. Will you have some tea? So here will is used to express offer, to request, and in your future. Okay. And here would. Next is would. Would is the past form of will. It is used to express request and offer. As will is used here, would you lend me your camera? So this is the request, that he is requesting that would you lend me your camera. And to express offer, would you like a cup of coffee? He is here in this sentence, he is offering for something, that would you like a cup of coffee. And next is said, now as been, it is used to express future action. Said is also used to express future action. I shall see him tomorrow. Okay, so I shall see him tomorrow. This is the future action. It expresses the future action, your future. And said is also used to express offer and suggestion. So for offer, said I carry the bag for you. Shall I carry the bag for you? It is offer. And for suggestion means when we suggest to someone, or when we give the suggestion to someone else, shall is used. So shall we go to the beach? So this is the suggestion. Means someone is suggesting here that shall we go to the beach. Next is should. Here should is the past form of shall. So it is used, should is used for to express necessity. Okay, you should apply for the job. So you should apply for the job. Here should is used to express necessity. And next is must. It is used to express necessity and certainty also. Here for to express necessity, I must get up at 5 tomorrow. Means it is necessary that at 5 tomorrow I will get up. So must is used to express necessity and to express certainty. She must be at home now. So here he is saying that it is certain, it is fixed that she must be at home. At present she must be at home. So to express certainty, must is used. Here student, the last modal is ought, and it is used to express necessity. Here you ought to obey your parents, but it is used with to. Okay, you ought to obey your parents. Here it is necessity that he is saying, means someone is saying to someone else that you ought to obey your parents. Here students, your exercise is given. In this exercise, match the sentences on the left. So here sentences are given on the left side with the uses of modals, and on the right side. On the right side, the uses of modals are given of these sentences. So here, I must make a phone call. So here must is used to express necessity. Okay, number one is mentioned here. Must is used to express necessity. And second sentence, she has walked a long way. She must be tired. Here, must is also used to express certainty, as I told you in the last column. And the next sentence, will you close the window, please? So here, will is the modal and it is used to express request. Okay. Here next is, we will be away next weekend. So will is also used here. Next sentence, in the fourth sentence, will is used to express future action. So we will be away next weekend. So this is the sentence of future. Next sentence is, she can speak French fluently. So she can speak French fluently means to express ability. Here, ability to express ability, fifth number is mentioned. And in the next sentence, shall I get a taxi for you? So shall is used here in this sentence, and shall is used to express here. Next number, offer. Okay, offer. And in the next sentence, shall we go for a swim? So shall we go for a swim? Shall is used, shall is also used to express here suggestion. Okay, suggestion, for suggestion shall is used. And next is that, can I go out? So can is used here in sentence. At, can is used to express here permission, means to take permission, shall is used. And in the ninth sentence, she may arrive tomorrow. So it is, may is used here, and may is used to express possibility. Okay, strong possibility, and might is used for weak possibility. And in the last sentence, you ought to help him. Ought is used to express necessity. Okay, so in this way your chapter auxiliaries and modal verbs completed. Thank you. Have a nice day.